AZF, the online platform for GATE Agriculture Engineering. And this is all about me. Today we are going to discuss the mass transfer topic. And I think most of the students will leave the topic because they think that it is very lengthy and very tough. And friends, it is tough. I will accept this. But I will, in this video, I am going to cover the that topics of mass transfer only from where the questions have been asked. जिस पोर्शन से हमारा क्वेश्चन आता है 80-90% जो क्वेश्चन आता है वो इट इज आस्क्ड फ्रॉम ए पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक सो आई विल गोइंग टू कवर ओनली दोज टॉपिक्स एंड दैट्स व्हाई यू शुड सी द वीडियो केयरफुली एंड कवर दिस टॉपिक्स ओनली बिकॉज इफ द क्वेश्चन आस्क्ड देन यू कैन इजली एबल टू सॉल्व एंड इट इज इफ इट इज आस्क्ड वेरी टफ क्वेश्चन देन नो वन इज एबल टू सॉल्व मीन्स इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर एनीवन टू सॉल्व So you should cover at least this portion only. Friends, first thing is Fick's law. Fick's law is equivalent to Fourier's law. Whatever we have studied in heat transfer, that is equivalent in mass transfer. But there, the heat flow is due to temperature difference. But here in case of Fick's law, it is due to concentration difference. Means, हमारा mass transfer में क्या होता है? Concentration का difference होता है, जिसकी वजह से heat flow होता है. बट फोरियर्स लॉ में क्या होता है टेम्परेचर का डिफरेंस होता है फ्रेंड्स कंसेंट्रेशन व्हाट इज कंसेंट्रेशन व्हेन आई विल गिव यू द एग्जांपल व्हेन आई मिक्स ए सॉल्यूशन ऑफ सुगर इन वाटर सपोज आई पुट वन स्पून ऑफ सुगर इन वाटर देन यू से दैट ए सॉल्यूशन इज लिटिल बिट स्वीट मीन्स कंसेंट्रेशन इज ऑफ सुगर इज लो But when I put 4 spoons of sugar in that solution, water, then you say that it is highly concentrated solution and it is more sweet. So friends, this is concentration. And now you see that mass flux. Mass flux NB is equal to MB divided by A. Means our mass flux hota hai, wo hota hai ki it is directly proportional you see here it is directly proportional to dc by dx means change in concentration by per unit length and here we use the constant that is dbc that is the concentration means the diffusion coefficient or diffusivity and friends you should take care the units of mass flux that is kg per second per meter square this is important And friends, you see that here I have written the mass flux in terms of concentration. And friends, here you see also minus sign is there. So you can clearly analyze that mass concentration difference always takes place from higher potential to lower potential. Means higher mass concentration to lower mass concentration. And when I am going to write it in terms of pressure, then we can correlate by using the ideal gas equation. I think all of you have studied the ideal gas equation that is PV is equal to nRT. And from there only we can correlate the concentration and pressure. C is equal to P by P, CA is equal to PA by RT. And friends, molecular diffusion of gases. Suppose two gases are present, gas A and gas B. And put in a container and after some time both these gases mixes. So friends, in this case when we are going to write the mass flux, then we can write it at A and Z means mass flux, flux rate of gas A is equal to minus dAB into dCA by dZ is equal to dAB into CA1 minus CA2 divided by Z2 minus Z1 is equal to dAB into PA1 minus PA2 divided by RT Z1 minus Z2 minus Z1. Means friends, you should take care here that CA1 and CA2 means concentration of gas A1 means gas A initially and gas A finally. Means हमें gas B से consider नहीं करना है, हमें केवल gas A का initial concentration and final concentration consider karna hai and also one more thing friends DAB means diffusivity diffusion constant coefficient of gas A we have to consider And friends, you see here, in for gas B, it is dBz is equal to dBa into CB1 minus CB2 divided by Z1 minus Z2 is equal to dBa is equal to PA into PB1 minus PB2 divided by RTZ1 minus Z2. Friends, here in case of gas B, you can clearly visualize that we are considering the pressure concentration of gas B only at initial and at final. में समय गैस A से कोई मतलब नहीं होता जब हम गैस B का फ्लक्स रेट कैलकुलेट कर रहे हैं तो. Friends, now see some important dimensionless numbers. That is, first one is Reynolds number. Friends, you can just simply see this slide, means carefully. If you see it carefully, then you can easily correlate in the examination and you can mark the option correct. Because very simple questions has been asked on this topics. So you should only see Reynolds number, ratio of inertia force and viscous force. Proud number is inertia force, gravitational force, like this, friends. And one more slide, friends, you should see, that is here's Seyrout number, Stanton number, Sesmith number, rotating Froude number. This also, friends, you should take care in your mind. Friends, important one is Reynolds number. That is, Reynolds number is equal to rho Vd by mu. I think all of you have studied in fluid mechanics also. But friends, you should take care about the mu. Mu is the dynamic viscosity, not the kinematic viscosity. Means dynamic viscosity. So you can know the formula. Dynamic viscosity is equal to kinematic viscosity into density. आपको ये चीज़ याद रखनी है. One more important thing is range of Reynolds number. I think you have studied. If it is less than 2000, then laminar flow. Greater than 4000, then turbulent flow. And between 2000 and 4000 is transient flow. Now friends, one more questions has been asked upon the natural convection and forced convection. They are simply asking in the question that which of the following numbers will represent the forced convection, which of the following will represent natural convection, and they have given the four options of dimensionless numbers. So I will give you the brief intro of natural and forced convection. Friends, for natural convection, it is represented by the Grashof number and Rayleigh's number. You have to remember this. And friends, you see this slide. Natural convection is also called the free convection. And free convection is represented by Grashof number. And forced convection is represented by Reynolds number. That's it. Nothing more about this. Now friends, you see the question. Here friends, initially the alcohol is present and its pressure is given, that is 5.532 kilopascal initial pressure is given. And friends, after some time the alcohol will vaporize, means its pressure will become zero, and it is present with inert gas in the atmosphere, means total atmospheric pressure is 101.325. And friends, it is asking about the log mean pressure of inert gas, inert air, means hame inert air ka pooch raha hai aur hame question mein given hai एल्कोहल का, मींस PA1 PA2 इनिशियली हमें एल्कोहल का गिवन है, हमें PB1 एंड PB2 कैलकुलेट करना होगा. आपको ये चीज ध्यान रखनी है कि यू कांट गो ब्लाइंडली दैट व्हाटएवर द प्रेशर्स गिवन एंड व्हाटएवर द डेटा गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन आई विल ब्लाइंडली अप्लाई. यू हैव टू बी वेरी स्पेसिफिक एंड वेरी कॉन्शियस दैट इट इज आस्किंग अबाउट द लॉग मीन प्रेशर वैल्यू ऑफ इनर्ट एयर. एंड फ्रेंड्स, the atmosphere consists of, here you can see according to this question, the atmosphere consists of inert air and alcohol. Initially alcohol pressure is 5.532 and finally it will evaporate, means its pressure become zero. So initially the total pressure P atmospheric is equal to 101.325 is equal to PA1 plus PB1 is equal to PA2 plus PB2, means initial pressure of both alcohol and inert gas is equal to atmospheric pressure is equal to final pressure of both alcohol and inert gas. So you calculate the PB1 is equal to 101.325 minus 5.532, and similarly PB2 you will calculate 101.3 minus 0. Friends, here by mistake I have written 2 times PB1. Friends, in first case it is PB1 and in second case it is PB2. Here little little bit mistake is there, so you can visualize and sort out. हमारा जो PB2 होगा वो होगा 101.325 minus 0 is equal to 101.325 and remaining things are easy. You simply put the log mean temperature difference you have studied, T1 minus T2 by. Similarly here you can write PB1 minus PB2 divided by ln PB2 by PB1, whatever you can write, you can get the answer. Friends, one more question has been asked upon this Seurat number. So friends, you can see here about the Seurat number. Seurat number is equal to HL by DAB. Friends, here H is the heat transfer coefficient, L is the length or diameter of droplet, and DAB is the thermal mass diffusivity constant coefficient. You see here in the question, it is given mass diffusivity coefficient is given, that is 3 into 10 to the power minus 4 meter square per second, and the diameter L is given, that is 100 micrometer, and 0.4 in meter per second is the H value is given. So you should put all these values HL by D and you will get the answer, that is 1/3 of mass transfer coefficient, that is the C option.